another very important message that he's sending through this Joe Arpaio thing. It's a message to his base. It's a message to anybody that's anti-Hispanic. It's a message to anybody that is...
America first. America first.
No, sweetheart, tell you what. I'm America first. And you don't get to tell me that I'm not.
No, I'm saying
but
he's
I'm also
America
not
first.
Anti-Hispanic.
He's
I'm not
America
anti-immigrant.
First.
I'm not anti-black. I'm not anti-transgender.
Neither are
I'm
all
not
the voters.
Anti-gay.
Neither are all the voters.
So you don't get
Trump.
To tell me that I'm not America first because I'm an immigrant and I'm a Hispanic. You're inferring it, and I'm a little over it.
Okay, but...
So then let me tell you, he's sending a message if he pardons Joe Arpaio. Try to control yourself from interrupting me because you're a little too close and you're getting into my danger zone. Do not interrupt a Latino.
I understand. I got
so
it.
So let me just tell you.
It's about
you
his ability to tell the truth about anything.
You just said that the administration
no, it's
was
not
going
to squelch. Look, you're trying to make this segment
Anna.
About something that it's completely not about.
No,
you
no,
talked
you
and
are.
Talked and talked.
You just
no, no.
want
you've
to
tried to make this about abortion.
President.
You've tried to make it about science. That's not about what it is. It's about the fact that the president of the United States goes out and lies either by Twitter or in person daily. Last week, he told us he had phone calls he did not have with people who did not call him on the phone, who he claimed told him things they did not tell him. That is a lie. Some of you may choose to believe alternate facts and live in an alternate universe. Some
I
of
don't.
Us choose to believe in a factual universe.
Mm-hmm. Strongly. What is happening now is that families are being separated. Babies are being torn from mothers' arms. They are being put in things that look like cages. That's why they don't let the U.S. senators in there, because they don't want people to be able to tell what's going on there. They don't want the pictures to come out because they know that the American people are people of love, are people that know that this is a country built on immigration, are compassionate people who believe in family unity and who are going to be shocked and terrorized and horrified
Anna,
by those images.
We're built on legal immigration. We're about
no,
legal
not.
Immigration. And
yeah,
if you
why
don't,
you, why don't you say that to all
children,
the... Listen,
don't
you know,
try
I,
to smuggle.
Hold on.
I can't. I, there is something I cannot stand as when you interrupt me. I let you speak until you're done.
All right, finish your point, Anna.
Well, you know, why don't you go tell the slaves that were brought here how we're built on legal immigration?
All right, that's not immigration.
Individually.
Okay, but let me tell you something. 70-some percent, 75-78% of Republicans are supporting Trump. 90% of Democrats are supporting Clinton.
Anna,
you want to talk facts?
First
that's
of all,
a fact.
Okay,
I want to apologize to you for being a millennial. I know millennials aren't allowed to have opinions in this day and age. I was working on campaigns.
Can we bring up the level of
let me play my old ancient Stradivarius for you.
I think the fact that this panel has descended.
Let me tell you something. Let me play my little violin for you, okay?
Look, I don't have it. I support the winner. I have no problem with that.
I'm
the one who's happy.
Jeb Bush lost. And you know what? I was unhappy that Jeb Bush lost, and it lasted me about a week. After that, I started supporting everybody other than Donald Trump.
How'd that work out for you?
I think he is a racist bigot who is destructive for the Republican Party.
Jeff,
you know
no
something? For you to compare Donald Trump to Abraham Lincoln, Ronald Reagan, and Jack Kemp really is just too much for me on an empty stomach in the morning, Jeffrey.
Even
but listen, I think that's a completely true. The reason that a lot of the Christian right is willing to call this a mulligan and look the other way mm-hmm. when they weren't
well, we
willing to do
Graham.
The same for a Bill Clinton mm-hmm. is because of a Gorsuch, because of a Kavanaugh,
true.
Because Donald Trump is shutting down the rights of LGBTQ because he doesn't
right.
support or does not recognize gotcha. Pride Month. Because he sides with the Baker instead of the LGBTQ.
What has he done to LGBTQ?
All of those things make those people happy. Oh, come on. What has he done to LGBTQ? First thing his administration did was curtail the rights of transgender students in public schools. He doesn't even recognize Pride Month, something that practically every administration has done for years since before Trump. And you know why he has to do it? Because he's on very thin ice. Number one, because he's full of flaws and full of sins. And because, nobody thought we were voting for John the Baptist. But did you think you were going to vote for Hugh Hefner? But also because he knows he's a hypocrite. He's
right.
playing evangelical right. He's playing Republican.
No,
he
he's
is
not.
A, you know,
well, he's, delivering
sheep
he's delivering on policy. He's delivering on policy.
He's delivering on what
tariffs.
They want. But they used to
tariffs,
want.
Tariffs, slobbering to Putin.
No,
that ain't.
No.
Actually, I was a Republican when the president you support was a Democrat. And I was a Republican when the president you support was an independent.
If you're a Republican, I'm Luis Fonsi. Come
maybe
on.
You this are Luis right. Fonsi. You can start singing Despacito here. But I am a Republican. I supported Ronald Reagan. I've supported every single Republican nominee
and,
for
and
president.
And donated to every, I mean,
so
to
has
Menendez.
I supported
to,
Bob Menendez.
To Debbie
you know
Wasserman
Schultz. So did Jared Kushner. So did Charlie Kushner. So did Donald Trump.
Right.
Okay.
So that doesn't bother you?
No, it doesn't bother
me. You know how to spell
me.
Hypocrisy? Or should I spell it out for you?
I'm just telling you.
He wouldn't do it. It's time that somebody looks at the camera and looks at him and calls him up and says, listen, you crazy lunatic 70-year-old man, baby, stop it. You are now the president of the United States, the commander-in-chief, and you need to stop acting like a mean girl because we just won't take it. We won't vote with you. We won't work with you. I can't start talking about tax reform. I can't start talking about healthcare reform because I can't get past the fact that we have a president who lacks the sufficient character. We have a president who is mean. We have a president who is nasty. We have a president who is immature, unstable, and just acts like a crazy person with anybody who attacks him because he's got thin skin and he is never going